Hello, and thank you for your interest in SDI. My name is Samantha Cheetham, and I am the Chief Executive Officer. Today, I'm going to introduce you to SDI and what we do. SDI is Australia's largest dental manufacturer, and we began 51 years ago here in Melbourne. Before we move on, I always like to recap on where we've come from, particularly for those that are less familiar with our business. We were established in 1972, and we've built this business into a successful manufacturing company where today we are exporting to more than 100 countries. Our success has been driven by our continuing focus on research and development, and through this, we have developed new and innovative products that meet the needs of our customers. We are very committed to innovation in filling materials such as composites and glass ionomers, cements, adhesives, tooth whitening, and small equipment. We have offices and warehouses in Germany, the USA, and Brazil, and sales teams in the UK, Ireland, France, Spain, Germany, Poland, Czech Republic, Canada, Australia, New Zealand, and distributors on all continents in most countries. Over 90% of our sales come from outside of Australia. SDI started as an amalgam company, amalgam being the silver fillings, but we focus our research and development, marketing and sales efforts on tooth-coloured fillings and their accessories, tooth whitening and small equipment. Glass ionomers and composites are the tooth-coloured fillings, and glass ionomers are wonderful for the teeth as they release calcium and fluoride to the tooth, helping to make them stronger. Composites are seen as more tooth-coloured and stronger. Tooth whitening is a super way to feel confident with your smile, and our Polar range is extremely strong and only available through the dentist. We have another category, small equipment, some lights which harden the fillings, and a mixing machine which mixes capsules. We've been recognised in a number of key categories within the industry regarding our restorative products, whitening products, curing lights, and the Riva range of products. The new products we develop and release to the dental market underpin SDI's growth with awards like the Innovative Company of the Year, recognition for our place in the market. One award I'd like to highlight is the one on the left-hand side of the slide. We were awarded Exporter of the Year at the Governor of Victoria Export Awards in November last year and subsequently named a finalist at the national level. This award is in recognition of our international success, competing against a wide sector of medical, healthcare, and biotechnology fields for products, technology, equipment, and services. We're extremely proud of this recognition, and we've built this success over 50 years into a successful manufacturing company where today we're exporting to more than 100 countries. For our highlights of this first half, it was a record half for the group with total sales of 50.5 million, up 9% on the prior corresponding period. This was driven by strong growth in both aesthetics and amalgam product categories. Although there's been some easing of inflationary pressures, we are still experiencing elevated costs, especially in freight costs, which are yet to return to pre-COVID levels. Because of these conditions and other factors, such as normal operating travel and an increase in marketing costs, EBITDA remained flat at 6.1 million, up slightly by 0.1% on the prior corresponding period. Debt increased over the period after the purchase of our new site, with this strategic purchase offering long-term benefits for the company and in the short term, catering for our expanding warehousing needs. The interim dividend of 1.5 cents per share, which is in line with the prior corresponding period and reflects the board's continuing confidence in the outlook for the business. This slide shows the regions where sales went in Australian dollars. The Americas, Europe, and Asia Pacific all performed well, with Middle East Africa slightly underperforming, reflecting inconsistent ordering patterns of some of the countries within that region. These performances reflect the return to normal operating conditions, but also the success with new product releases and, of course, market share gains. During the pandemic, we made sure there was no unmet demand, and this helped gain market share across the regions. In August 2022, we announced the purchase of a 6-acre site to support the short-term needs of adding important warehouse capacity and the longer-term strategic plan for expanded manufacturing capacity. We are currently finalizing the renovation work on the warehouse, which will see increased production efficiencies for SDI. When we complete this, we are scheduled to relocate in July 2023. We've now received FDA approval for our newest product, Stela, in the USA, TGA approval in Australia, and Anvisa approval in Brazil. We have already received first orders of Stela in non-European US regions that do not require formal approvals. In the US, we expect the first orders to start in July this year. We're excited by Stela and the opportunity it creates, not only as an amalgam replacement product, but more importantly in the aesthetic category, given its strength and natural tooth color advantage. Finally, we remain committed to investment in automation to drive manufacturing efficiencies. An example of this, we've recently purchased a high-speed production machine, which will increase syringe output, moving from one to approximately eight per minute. This is a great example of operating efficiencies with a short payback and adds to our ability to manage new and existing product growth. Our product development is something we're proud of, and next I want to highlight the rigorous process we go through before our products come to market. Our commitment to research and development has underpinned SDI's success over many years. We manufacture and sell world-leading products on the global stage, with our core IP underpinning these advancements. It's important to be aware of the development cycle that precedes any of our product launches. Our team of science followed a development path with a focus on the manufacturing readiness levels, MRLs. These begin at level one with new ideas that may come from university collaboration, a new challenge identified by one of our team, or simply a new improvement to an existing product we have. As these projects develop, they move through the MRL stages, starting at proof of concept, then to formulation stage, then validation and quality assurance before the pilot phase, and then finally to full-scale manufacturing. This cycle can be as long as 5 years, with the sales cycle to follow potentially a similar period of time as we engage dentists and the key opinion leaders in the industry. We operate in a highly regulated industry, and our investments in research development are key to manufacturing our relevance and advances in the market. Along with many other organisations, we realise the importance of ESG and constantly assess ways we can improve our impact on the environment and help support our communities. While relatively early in our journey, the board and management team are committed to making significant progress in the coming years, and we'll share our progress over time. Some initiatives to share include the appointment of a qualified engineer to the role of environmental officer. This person is tasked with ensuring we are meeting expectations and looking to make continuous improvements on the way we impact our environment. An internal ESG group has recently begun making suggestions towards positive initiatives that can start to be implemented within SDI's warehousing, and we are looking forward to the suggestions that are presented to make our working environment better. Finally, for many years, SDI have been proud of their community work and taking the opportunity to assist disadvantaged communities. Our work, for example, with Rotary in East Timor is just one example how we have assisted in improving the dental hygiene of people who may not have those benefits. The company's strategic priorities are in aesthetics and whitening. They continue to be our focus for new product development through our R&D team. As I've already highlighted, SDI's aesthetic product, Stela, is on schedule to be released in several markets at the International Dental Show held in Cologne, Germany, this month, along with several other key products. We remain committed to ongoing investment in R&D, and our aim is to release one to two products per year, and that is on target. These include Reva Sam Auto Mix and Stella, which are on schedule to be released from this month. And they are in the aesthetic category. We continue to focus on improving operating manufacturing efficiencies via automation and new site relocation. And lastly, although we continue to be challenged by elevated logistics costs, operating conditions in nearly all countries are back to pre-pandemic levels, and we are focused on capturing the ongoing benefits from the strong base built in SDI's target markets. Thanks very much, everyone, for listening, and enjoy the rest of the ASX presentations.